in the background.
A study carried out by epidemiologists under the Uganda Public Health Fellowship Program to ascertain the knowledge, attitude and practices of traditional healers regarding management of Ebola virus disease in Kassanda and Mwende districts in September 2022 reveals that traditional healers knew the causes and symptoms of the virus. Besides, their practices were poor, which puts them and the patients at a high risk, which is partly because there are no guidelines and that they have not been considered in the formal public health system.
In conclusion, the study revealed that traditional healers had fairly good knowledge, but practices were poor. Specifically, we found that IPC was very poor, suggesting they were at risk and potentially putting patients at risk. However, there are no guidelines on what we want the traditional healers to do during Ebola outbreaks. This is because we haven't brought them on board in the formal system.
Epidemiologists believe that bringing traditional healers on board is as urgent as immediate because many people consider seeking treatment from them.
Traditional healers are part of our society and people choose to go to seek help, to seek treatment where they want to, okay? So if someone seeks healthcare from a traditional healer, they cannot be stopped, okay? But remember that this is an epidemic-prone country. And then also our borders are surrounded by also other epidemic-prone countries. So it means that any one time we could get an infectious disease coming in to the country. So it is very important that everyone in their category, not only traditional healers, everyone wherever they are, gets to be aware, is taught, and they get to be concerned about these diseases. Otherwise, we'll not be able to overcome these epidemics.
On the other hand, epidemiological studies on healthcare-associated infections and prevalence of post-traumatic stress disorder among Sudan virus disease survivors and family members during the outbreak in Uganda have posted noteworthy findings, as researchers explain.
Notably, family members were as equally affected by mental disorder as SVD survivors, and yet continue to be underserved.
The director of the Uganda National Institute of Public Health under the Ministry of Health is optimistic that this data is going to inform the scientific world about the advancements in science, which will in turn help in responding to epidemic outbreaks in the country in the right ways.
It's going to inform the scientific world about advances in science, because everything that you've seen that fellows have done is discovering a lot that you can do. Remember, each outbreak is unique. You are not going to follow a textbook material, what we call generic information. Textbook material does not help in outbreak response. Each outbreak is unique. So that is one unique thing that the fellowship has brought, and now we are telling the public that whenever you see an outbreak that comes, we need to respond in a more unique way, not the way we've done it before or last year.
This was during the 9th Uganda National Field Epidemiology Conference, commemorated under the theme, The Role of Field Epidemiology in Strengthening Public Health Emergency Response in Uganda. Among other functions, the Uganda National Institute of Public Health is mandated to coordinate disease outbreaks and other health emergencies, preparedness and response in the country.
We have lost
Derek Asaba reporting for the news.